Hateful Yale psych professor diagnosed Trump, gets humiliated as her secret is exposed. The Trump-hating Yale psychology professors who wanted to forcibly constrain President Donald Trump and said he suffers from a mental impairment has just suffered a humiliating blow as a dirty secret she surely wanted to remain hidden has been made public. President Donald Trump recently came under attack from Yale University psychology professor Bandy Lee, who publicly diagnosed him with mental disease and recently met with lawmakers on Capitol Hill to disparage Trump with her professional opinion. Well, Lee isn't running at the mouth anymore after it was revealed that she isn't actually a licensed psychiatrist. That's right, Lee is retreating into whatever hole she climbed out of to attack Trump now that it has come to light that she isn't licensed to practice psychology in her home state of Connecticut. You would think that someone with such a high level of education behind them wouldn't be that stupid. Apparently, Lee wanted to set a new precedent. As Lee's dirty secret hit the news and social media, she responded by deleting her Twitter account and withdrawing from the public eye. Thanks to the good people over at Campus Reform, it has also been discovered that, according to the state of Connecticut, Lee's physician, surgeon license expired in 2015, and her application for reinstatement has been pending for the last 3 years. As the truth about Lee unfolded, it was also discovered that her controlled substance registration for practitioner license has apparently lapsed, expiring in February 2017. Does this woman have any self-respect? Why on earth would she stick her giant liberal ego out there to attack Trump, knowing that she had so much to hide? This is the problem with liberals, not a lot of common sense in action. According to Campus Reform, Lee responded to the bombshell revelations about her lack of license by saying, "I need only one license." Lee has not yet provided additional information on precisely which license that is, and according to the state in which she lives, she allegedly has none. After Lee made her infamous trip to Capitol Hill and drew such negative attention from millions of Americans, the psychiatry community tried to distance itself from the liberal tool without mentioning her name. The American Psychiatric Association, APA, released a recent statement in which it condemned the diagnoses of public officials, like the president, whom psychiatrists have not personally examined, invoking what is commonly referred to as the Goldwater Rule. We at the APA call for an end to psychiatrists providing professional opinions in the media about public figures whom they have not examined, whether it be on cable news appearances, books, or in social media, the statement read, according to the Washington Examiner. Armchair psychiatry or the use of psychiatry as a political tool is the misuse of psychiatry and is unacceptable and unethical, the APA concluded. In response to the APA's rebuke of their politicized behavior, Lee and a colleague claimed that it's perfectly okay to question the president's mental state, since they are psychiatrists. In Lee's initial interview, she even went so far as to warn that Trump could cause the end of the world as we know it, as seen in the clip below. This is textbook liberal behavior and one of the huge reasons that the Democratic Party suffered such an unbearable defeat in the last presidential election. The elitist attitude never seems to end with people like Bandy Lee. It seems as if someone in the political world went and dug Lee up and asked her to stick her neck out for the left. Honestly, Lee is giving psychiatrists a bad name. There are people in her field who truly care about providing a professional level of care for patients who have a real mental disease. Bandy Lee, on the other hand, has proven that she is primarily interested in taking cheap shots at President Donald Trump because she is a liberal activist before she is anything else. Too bad for the Democrats, their secret weapon had a dirty secret of her own.